All eyes are on Providence Mayor Jorge Alorza's plan to restructure the fire department.
Now, it's part of a plan the mayor says will save taxpayers money, but we've learned legislation is pending at the State House that would take similar power away from cities and towns in the future. And it's a bill that has caught the attention of mayors and other city and town leaders. Eyewitness News with more live coverage at 11.
Kelly Sullivan is live in Providence from the Mobile Newsroom with more details for us now.
Well, in order to save the city millions, Mayor Jorge Alorza issued an order to change firefighters' hours, but there's currently a bill in the General Assembly that would take away some of the power from city and town leaders to make it more of a level playing field when it comes to negotiating with fire unions. A battle between Mayor Jorge Alorza and Fire Union Local 799 is heating up. The mayor, looking to reduce the platoons or shift schedules and add more hours to the work week in what he says will save about $5 million per year. Alorza, able to make these changes after a state Supreme Court decision back in January, gave cities and towns the right to force firefighters to work up to 14 more hours. But perhaps what's most important that's been left up for interpretation is how firefighters are compensated. That could mean whether they receive a higher base salary or overtime. Providence Senator Paul Jabor is co-sponsoring a bill that would leave these negotiations up to the municipality and fire union.
The bill is in no way intended to create any form of abuse, nor give any one party, whether it be the city or the fire department, an upper hand in how the hours are managed for the firefighters.
In the mayor's first big fight, Eyewitness News political analyst Joe Fleming says this could show his strength if everything works out. If not, the union could give him problems for the rest of his time in office.
He's saying this is going to save millions of dollars. If it does, obviously the taxpayers would like that. And if they feel the fire protection is still the same, they'll be happy with it. However, if they feel there's a lack of fire protection or it's not as good, then it could have negative effects for the mayor.
And that was Kelly Sullivan reporting. Now, we reached out to the mayor's office this evening. His press secretary tells us the mayor has delayed implementation and looks forward to negotiating with the union to come to terms with the administrative order.